It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Dallas, Texas. I'm here with MMA legend Quentin Rampage Jackson. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
I'm doing wonderful. Listen, brother, we're here. It's fight week. We're here for the Trailer Triad Combat here in Arlington, Texas, the home of the Texas Rangers, man, MMA team. You know, this is as far as a new era, brother. We're seeing a lot more and more as far as combat sports, a lot of more professional fighters willing to mix it up, whether it's in the MMA world, bare knuckle world, or even professional boxing. Explain to us the opportunity that was presented to you in order for you to become a coach for the Team MMA.
Well, Shannon Briggs and I have been going at it back and forth, and we've been trying to get a fight against each other, and Triller came up with this idea, boxers versus MMA fighters. Because that's what me and Shannon was planning on doing. We was planning on doing one boxing match and one MMA fight. And we putting the boxers versus the MMA guys, because boxers are always calling us out and MMA guys going boxing. But no boxers came over to fight us. I think James Toney was the last one that did it that I know of, you know. So, you know, I jumped at the opportunity to come here and see what they're doing and be a team captain for MMA, because, you know, I represent MMA. I love MMA. It's my sport. And I think that MMA fighters, we are the real fighters. The boxers, you know, no disrespect. I like boxing. I've been training boxing for at least 11, 12, 13 years now. I really enjoy boxing, and it's a tough craft, but I just feel like MMA fighters are better fighters.
Yeah, you also mentioned, you know, here in the podium that, you know, fight fans around the world, they want to see guys like, you know, what there's always that old debate, right? An MMA fighter versus a boxer, or they can't do what MMA fighters do. MMA fighters can't do what boxers do. But as you mentioned, in your personal opinion, obviously, you've accomplished so much in your career. You said that in your opinion, you feel that MMA fighters are just tougher, they're stronger, and they just have more of that, you know, that killer instinct in them. Would you agree with that assessment?
Yeah, we're tough. Like, we get elbowed in the face. We get kneed in the face. We get kicked. Boxers couldn't take all that. You know, I don't see a boxer getting elbowed in the face and still trying to, you know, keep going in the fight. I see if a boxer get elbowed in the face, they're going to tap out. They're going to quit. They're going to lay down. They're going to cry. They're going to look like a basketball player. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, look, you've had experience coaching. I know you've been on the UFC Tough Show. You've had, you know, a lot of these guys as well. I mean, Frank Mir, Matt Mitrione. Yeah. These guys are, they're no slouch. You know what I mean?
I coached against Matt Mitrione on Ultimate Fighter.
That's right. Yeah. Well, look, I mean, how do you, as far as separate the fighter's mindset and just kind of attempt to establish that coaching mindset? Because you're a fighter. So when you go in there, you have to kind of keep your emotions in check for your fighter, but you have to kind of guide them to victory. How difficult is that?
Well, you know, I'm not these guys' coach today. These guys train for their fight. You know, I wasn't there in their training camps.
Gotcha.
But, you know, I'm here to back them up 100% and encourage them and let them know that, you know, they're representing MMA and go out there and give it their all, you know?
Well, let me ask you this. You know, with the UFC being what it is and professional boxing being what it is, a lot of people say, you know, boxing is dead. You know, UFC's taking over. How do you see as far as the boxing landscape? Are you a student of the game as far as do you keep up with it? Do you watch a lot of these fighters?
I don't watch a lot of fights, UFC or boxing. I just watch the ones I want to watch. I don't watch every single one. But I don't see boxing as being dead. I see the YouTubers are bringing a little bit more excitement.
That's right.
I know some people have mixed feelings about that, but for me, I think it's entertainment. You know, it's entertainment. And, you know, some people complain over anything, but, you know, entertainment is entertainment. And I think UFC and Bellator and all the other organizations, I think they're doing great right now because their fighting is in the cage and stuff is very entertaining. And sometimes over the years, which made me stop watching a lot of boxing, was that boxers was like they wasn't fighting in the fights, like they was fighting trying to win rounds and take some rounds off, and they got boring after a while.
Yeah, I completely agree. And you know, a lot of people also say a lot of that has to do with them also becoming businessmen. They want to, you know, they're trying to keep their O as much as possible, because it's not like MMA. MMA guys will fight the best, in which boxing is just very difficult to do.
Right.
Because, you know, there's
not a lot of undefeated fighters in MMA, because we don't have journeymen like boxing. So you get in there and you get in there.
Well, look, we appreciate your time, champ. Is there any last shout-outs you want to give to any of your friends, any of your fans or family that's back home and watching?
Well, I just want everybody to know I love everybody, and I want everybody to have a positive mindset. You know, we're going through some crazy stuff right now, but I fought a lot of things, and I've been a fighter my whole life. Everything about me is a fighter. I fight everything, and you never lose a fight with positivity.
Well, we appreciate your time, man. Those were some words of wisdom. Again, it's your boy Jim the Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, signing off with one of the baddest dudes on the planet, Rampage Jackson.